Welcome to my new video. In this video I will introduce you the SAP GUI structure. You will learn how the relation between the main GUI elements is in SAP, and how you can define the GUI elements. The main elements in SAP GUI are, GUI Application, GUI Connection, and GUI Session. GUI Application represents the process where all SAP GUI activities occur. There can only be one GUI application object instantiated. In the code, this means, we can only have app, without a number, because we are only allowed to have one application open. GUI connection represents the connection between SAP GUI and an application server. An instance of GUI application accepts one or more connections from a GUI connection to the SAP systems available for scripting. This means, we can have connection 0, connection 1, connection 2, etc. GUI session. Each instance of GUI session corresponds to a new session in SAP. GUI session contains at least one instance of GUI main window. This means, we can have session 0, session 1, session 2, etc. Now I will present you the relation between the GUI elements. One GUI application can have an infinite number of connections. One connection can have up to 6 sessions. One session can have only one GUI main window. But one session can have an infinite number of GUI modal window. In this section we see an example for SAP application. This window is for the open SAP application. We are only allowed to have one application open. On the left we see the connections. This list contains all the systems that we can open. Each time a system is started, this is then a connection. When we start a system, a session is automatically opened. This session always has a main window, as we can see right now. You can know which session you are in, by reading the number below. In this example we are in the first session, and this is 0 as an index. I am now opening a new session. We can see again below, that we are currently in the second session. This is then equal to 1 as an index. I open a new session again. We are now in the third session. Index is 2. Now I am going to present you the elements in the main window. As mentioned before, every session always has a main window, and could have several modal windows. What we are currently seeing, is the main window. This window has several elements. I will explain these in detail. Main window is always window 0. In context, when we are in the first connection and the first session, this window is defined in this way. Application, connection 0, session 0, window 0. There is a GUI menu bar in every main window. There are various menu items in the GUI menu bar. The first element is defined like this. Menu bar, menu 0. The second element is, menu bar, menu 1. If we want to define an item from the menu, it is defined like this. Menu bar, menu 1, and then the index for the item, for example for the second item in the list, it is menu 1. Together is the item then so defined, menu bar, menu 1, menu 1. And so on we go on like this. The next element is GUI toolbar 1. The index for it is, 0. That means, we can define this element so, window 0, toolbar 0. If we want to define an item in this toolbar, we can do that like this. For example for button save, ID is button 11. So the ID is, window 0, toolbar 0, button 11. The next item is, GUI title bar. It is defined as, window 0, title. The next element is GUI toolbar 2. The index for it is, 1. That means, we can define this element so, window 0, toolbar 1. We can also define the buttons in this toolbar, like in the first toolbar. The difference only is the index of the toolbar, and the ID for each button. The next item is the status bar. It is at the bottom. The ID for this element is, window 0, S bar. The first element in the status bar is the pane. This contains the text from SAP when we do something in SAP. The ID for pane is window 0, S bar, pane. Now I am going to switch to another window in SAP to present more elements. This area in the middle is called GUI user area. This contains most of the buttons and fields. The ID for it is window 0, user. If we want to define an element in this area, the ID for the element is always like this, window 0, user, and then the ID of the element. For example, account text field has this ID. So we can define this element then so, window 0, user, ctxtbkpf, bukrs. We see different types of elements here in the user area. I will briefly mention these. These fields are GUI text fields. We can use these fields to write data in them, or also to read data from them. These elements are GUI checkbox. You can check these boxes, or also uncheck them. These are radio buttons. You can select one of them. After we have learned the elements in SAP, I will show you what a code looks like if you want to implement automation in SAP. First, we define the SAP application. Then the connection. After that, we define the session. We see how each element inherits from the previous element. Session inherits from connection. Connection from application. Application from SAP GUI Auto. When defining the connection, we see children 0. That means we have taken the first connection. It's the same for session. We define the first session. Now we define the main window. We take the session variable, because it is inherited from all previous variables. So from application and connection. So we don't need to write the session, connection and application in the ID, because these are included in session variable. When we don't use session variable, but application, we should write the ID like so, connection 0, session 0 and then window 0. The first variant is simpler, so we will always work with session variable. Now we can use the main window variable that we have defined, with a function that maximizes the main window. We always write the variable and then the function. In summary, to define an element in SAP, we need the following, dim and the name for the element, for example main window, then as object. Then we write the name of the element again, equal, session.findById. And then the ID of the element. This was a rough explanation for scripting in SAP, how to write the code and what the structure is like in SAP. But you can also record the code using the SAP Recoder. I will show you how to do this. Click on the gear icon, then on script recording and playback. To record a new script, click on the red button in the middle. Now you can write the information and select buttons, etc. Everything you do will be recorded and saved as a code file. When you are done, click the yellow button to stop recording. Now navigate to the path to open the code file. At the beginning you can see the connection to the SAP application, and the definition of connection and session variables. Then you can see how to maximize the main window, write the transaction. Click the execute button, select the radio button document type. Write the currency in the text field and check the checkbox. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like and comment. See you in the next video.